This is a food forest with an understory of mushrooms, logs. And what I just discovered this morning is more mushroom. I put pleurotus, oyster mushroom growing on logs, and maybe others. So I put sponges there that I wet to actually keep the moisture. But I was just coming out with my little knife to cut the oyster mushroom when I discovered something I want to share with you. You know what it is? There's the spores. Look at that. They're the spore of the pleurotus. So now this is a kind of white pleurotus. That is, there's many species of pleurotus, at least 15 different edible species. And this particular white one is quite aggressive and very freely self-sporing. And that's what has happened here, so that's taken care of. I've got no worries about that. I don't have to resow them. It's a little bit like a shiitake mushroom. Japanese growers in Japan used to let the shiitake spore itself, because the shiitake can do that too. But because they mutate in a way very, 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 very profusely, very quickly, mushroom. And so you always end up having different strands of different type of mushroom. And this one, this white one, is a good strand because it self-perpetuates. And that's what I like the best. Look again. It's pretty clear, isn't it? Or what I can do too is to take the mushroom and let it spore in other places, in other logs, like all those ones. But here I've got Reishi mushroom. I can actually show you one. That's a Reishi. Oh my gosh, it's a beautiful one.